Good evening, all the participants, and it is a beautiful day to learn more about homeopathy. And today's topic is also very interesting, which is susceptibility, and we are going to learn this concept according to Dr. Kent, Dr. Roberts, and what Dr. Stuart Close has to say about it. Okay, so let's begin. So let us begin with understanding, what actually susceptibility means. According to dictionary, what it says is the state or fact of being likely or liable to be influenced or harmed by a particular thing. So, for example, if there's a person who, lacks exercising, so it increases his susceptibility to various kinds of diseases. Okay, so anything that makes a person very liable or very prone to getting influenced or harmed by a particular thing, this state is said to be the state of susceptibility, or a person being susceptible. Okay, so let's begin what Kent philosophy has to say about it. So, Master Kent starts with explaining what is given in 6th edition of Organon. 6th edition of Organon doesn't really emphasize on the word susceptibility, but a concept is derived from it, which is given in several aphorisms, that is aphorism 30, aphorism 31 and 32. Okay. So, it says, what does it say? Let us understand that. So a human being is more powerfully affected by medicines than natural morbid stimuli. So whatever natural morbid stimuli are there, what is more powerful than the diseased stimuli is that the, stimuli which medicines produce in our body. So that is more stronger. So medicinal stimuli is more stronger. So this is point one. Okay. Then natural diseases are cured and they overcome by administration of suitable medicines. Whenever you give a homeopathic similar medicine, that is the way how the inner disorder gets cured, the deranged vital force gets cured, and the natural disease which is existing in the body, that will go away. Okay, so in whose hand is the regulation of those? That is in a physician's hand, that is in our hands. So therefore it is said that the power of the medicinal force is more powerful, because it is in the hand of the physician to regulate the doses. Okay, so what happens when a human being is exposed to inimical forces? Inimical forces means, any psychical forces, any stress factors are there, or environmental factors are there, if a person is exposed to extremes of temperature, okay, things like that. So both psychical and physical forces, okay. So when a human being is exposed to these forces, what happens is that there is an alteration of state of health, which is not really necessary. Only those human beings who are susceptible to those conditions will be affected. So either a person, a group of people will be affected because of, very cold temperature, and there will be a group of people who won't be affected by such temperature. Okay. But when sufficiently disposed, the and susceptible to the attack, then alteration of health takes place. So when this person is his vital forces susceptible to this extreme temperature, only then he will be affected, and the alteration of health or the vital force will be deranged, and then after the vital force is deranged, he will develop certain signs and symptoms which we call as disease. So what is the role of the physician? What can we do in this? So the very most important thing is that he should have knowledge of potentization, how to, regulate the doses, what dose is required. Okay, so this is very important. then the dose of medicine given should be such that the disease susceptibility is satisfied, and the dose should be enough to produce change in the body, to bring back the disordered state which has occurred in the body. Okay, so we have the advantage of change of potency. Okay, if you know, like, there are various potencies, we all know, from 30 to 200 to 1m to lm potencies. Okay, so things like that. So we as a physician have an advantage to regulate and change these potencies whenever it is required, and this enables us to suit varying susceptibilities of sick man. So a person's susceptibility could vary after a period of time, not necessary that it will remain the same. So in order to satisfy this, we would have to change the dosage, okay, so which is in our hands. This advantage the physician has, okay. So the ability of the body to offer resistance, okay, that is what is called a susceptibility. So the resistance to what do we offer resistance? To the causes that are flowing into the body. So according to Master Kent, it is the flow of influx into the body and the ability of the body to offer resistance. That is how he defines susceptibility to be. Okay, so what happens when we become diseased? Now let us understand. So beginning of the disease, what happens when the disease really starts getting into us, what happens is that the resistance of the body reduces. So when the resistance to all these surrounding causes is getting reduced in a person, what will happen is that he will become very susceptible to his surroundings, and he'll start getting affected because of these causes, and he would fail to provide a strong resistance to resist these causes. And these, what will happen is that as a result, that there is no barrier or resistance that the body is able to protect itself. So the these causes will flow inside the man, and in turn this will result into disease. So now disease has formed into the body. Okay, so what is our role? We would have to give him a Simlimam remedy. So administration of similar homeopathic medicine is required. Okay, but very important is that it should be in the right potency. Why? Because the susceptibility should be satisfied, and then how the cure will take place. Okay, so what are the particular reasons for this is that the medicine should fit the varying degrees of susceptibility. So this is point one. And the second thing is that medicine has greater power of affecting the state of health than the natural disease. So this is the law, okay, behind the medicinal power and the natural disease force which is formed inside the body. So who is more powerful? It is the medicinal force that is more powerful. Okay, so but for cure to occur, the dose given is very important. So only the dose sufficient to produce the change must be given. We should not give doses repeatedly, or if not required, if the case does not require frequent repetitions, or also very high doses will do really harm to the patient. Okay, so how would we know? If you administer a certain dosage and you start that there are changes started to occur and there are generals improving, so what is our duty is to wait and watch. Okay, so what would happen if we do not administer the medicine correctly? So in situation one, there's an example that if the person is robust, okay, he's having a robust constitution, So if a remedy which is not homeopathic, okay, which is not similar to his state, if that is given, what would happen? Okay, let's see. So, you know, changes will occur which will show as if the patient is better, but improvement will be temporary. Okay, so then situation two. So in situation two, there could be a delicate patient, you know, whose reaction is very slow. So if unnecessary repetition is done in this case, this will prevent the human to get into the state of order. So he is already into the state of disordered vital force with his natural disease. And if you keep, you know, unnecessary repetitions, if you do, then what would happen is that you will not be able to bring the state of health into order back again. Then situation third, that if medicine that is not homeopathic, okay, again, if this the similar remedy is not given, then what will happen is that medicine will act upon artificial susceptibility. Okay, because of these repeated dosages given, there will be artificial susceptibility that will be produced, and it will act upon that. And in turn, it will turn to be no benefit to the patient. Okay. So even this practice is wrong and we should avoid it. Then, if potency outside his own degree of susceptibility is given, then again, what would happen is that human economy will be damaged by such medicinal power. We do not want to do this, okay? This will be very harmful for the patient, and you know, as a physician, we do not want to cause harm to our patients. So it takes years to bring the state of order and restore him back to health in this case. So how our cure should be rapid, gentle, and permanent restoration of health. So we do not want to cause our patient to, you know, suffer agony for over, you know, years together. So this we should avoid. Then let us now understand what is the concept of Dr. Stuart Close. He says, general capability of living organism of receiving impressions is what is said to be susceptibility. So, you know, we are living organisms and we have certain capability inside of us to receive impressions. Now, receiving impressions could be, you know, any stress factor. You know, if somebody insults one person, okay, he could be profoundly affected and, you know, would become quiet, or, you know, would go into dwelling or brooding or things like that. Or it could be a capability of receiving environmental impressions, okay? Like if a person is exposed to a sun, you know, he would develop fever, or he would, on exposure to sun, he could develop vertigo, so things like that. So the general capability of living organism of receiving certain impressions is what is called to be susceptibility by Dr. Stuart Close. And the power to react to the stimuli. So one is receiving the impressions, and second is power of reacting to that stimuli. So, you know, two things are dependent on this. One is the elevation of the disease, the increase of the disease, and second is even the cure of disease is dependent on this. So let us now understand how does cure depend on it. When homeopathic simulimum is given, the organism reacts to impressions of the curative remedy. Okay, whatever remedy is given, for example, you know, if you give aconite, for example, in a patient who is very anxious and he has gone into a panicky state, okay, what would happen is that this organism or this patient will receive the impression of the curative remedy, which is, you know, these symptoms, okay. We are going to give him, administer him a remedy which is similar to his disease symptoms. So he will, you know, react to the impression of this curative remedy, and then the signs and symptoms will disappear and the health will be restored back. So then what Dr. Stuart Close says is that susceptibility includes, you know, affinity to particular diseases. We see that various drugs which are there, they have sphere of actions also. Okay, so they have a particular affinity or, you know, even people, as peoples, they have a certain affinity to developing, you know, cold and coryzas, or, you know, tendency of developing, you know, some glandular affections, you know, maybe tonsillitis. So susceptibility also includes this affinity to, you know, suffer from particular diseases. Then, you know, attraction, if attraction is another thing, then, you know, certain desires are there. Every individual has, you know, different desires, and hunger and, you know, needs. So all of these are present also in a normal human being. But when does the problem comes? When, you know, this is not in, you know, balance or harmony. When, you know, these desires or these things, you know, they go out of control, or they become morbid, or, you know, they become perverted, then what happens is that, you know, it results into disease. Okay. So, what is another thing to note is that, you know, the highest degree of susceptibility exists towards the most similar remedy. The similimum, which, you know, Master Hanuman says, you know, that remedy will have the highest degree of susceptibility, okay, which a person could, you know, must receive the, you know, remedial susceptibility. So a physician can take two roads. One is the straight road, you know, you take all the symptoms, you take, you go deeper into the patient, you elicit all the, you know, important symptoms from, you know, location, sensation, modalities, concomitant, mental symptoms, physical generals, okay. You take all of these and, you know, you derive the similimum, and, you know, you take a straight road, you give the remedy, you cure the patient. Or, you know, another way could be, you know, zigzag. You know, when Master Kent says where, you know, that you can give a remedy that is, that could be partially similar, and you know, when certain symptoms get cured and patient comes up again, you know, certain symptoms get cured and another are remaining, so those would be accessory symptoms, you again take the totality and give a remedy. So like that, zigzag way. If similimum is given, he will be cured and he will become healthy. So that would be the, you know, ideal cure. So what, as a physician, our role is conserve the normal susceptibility, okay? That is the state of normal reactivity, where a person could react normally in a situation and not out of proportion, okay? Like, you know, out of proportion, how could you say? Like, you know, if somebody hits you and the anger is so much that, you know, you have the, you know, desire to go and, you know, kill that person maybe. So this is, you know, very out of proportion and very violent and like that. So this is just one example. So what to do when susceptibility is diminished or there is deficient reaction? So especially in chronic diseases, this could be seen that, you know, the reaction is very deficient or diminished. So in this case, you need to give an intercurrent remedy. Okay, and what if the excessive reaction is there? So this may be seen in some cases where, you know, a person is suffering from aggravation. You give any remedy, he suffers from aggravation, okay, without corresponding improvement. So we would conclude that it is a case of general hypersensitiveness. And to this, Master Bonding Hussain has listed a few remedies that if the state requires and the state matches the state of the patient matches, then, you know, the remedies like chamomilla, coffea, china, etc. He has listed a few remedies. So these could be given in such patients. Next is the concept of Dr. H.A. Roberts. Okay. So what he says is that primarily susceptibility is defined as the reaction of organism to external and internal influences. Everything is influenced more or less by the environment, as we already discussed. So one example could be, take for example a polar bear. Okay, so he can survive extreme colds. Okay, but if another species or another animal goes into this environmental state, he would not thrive, or he would rather not survive in this environment. Another is that if, we all know that, the region where we stay is said to be tropical region. So, the forests which are there in India, so tigers are found mostly in India. Okay. So Bengal tiger thrives in humid tropical regions. Okay. So that would not be suitable for some other species. So everything is influenced by more or less by the environment. Then another example could be, seashore improves one person's condition, while for the other it makes it worse. Then this is the reason why sentence Master H.A. Roberts has put forward, which is one man's meat is another person's poison. So also what happens when a drug is proved, one group of people will show wonderful proving, and there'll be another set of people or another set of group which will show no reaction. So why does this happen? Because of the susceptibility. So it is an impression of vacuum in an individual. Now this is very important. How can we understand the expression of vacuum? Imagine there's a closed ball, okay, and there's vacuum inside of it, but as soon as a hole is made, okay, there's any hindrance in the continuity of that ball, where inside vacuum is there, what would happen is that it will try to grab all the air inside of it. So this is one example, this is one expression of how vacuum attracts into itself various things. Okay, so see, in the form of desire for certain kind of food. So people would have different kinds of food, okay, and really love to eat it, really have desire for eating ice creams or chocolates or sour food, for pickles, so things like that, or they could take a lot of salt, they could desire a lot of salt. So vacuum attracts and pulls the things most needed. So what is required inside the body, or what could be the state of deficiency. So what happens is that vacuum attracts and pulls the things that are most needed in the body, that are on the same plane of vibration as wants in his body. So that is how we understand this. Then attractive force of susceptibility. Susceptibility has something which is called as, it is a attractive force. So which attracts disease force towards it. What does it do is that it will attract the disease force towards it. For example, children are more susceptible to various contagious diseases. We all know that, they get a lot of certain children, they get a lot of diarrhea, and they get a lot of coryzas, so like that. So why is this? Because they have extreme miasmatic influence that is surfaced. So this is the reason why they are more susceptible and prone to getting these diseases. So what we need to do is treat this miasmatic influence. So what would happen when we gave a homeopathic remedy, that we would fill this vacuum which is present in the sick person, okay, and also his natural susceptibility. After giving similar homeopathic remedy, the susceptibility of medicine will satisfy the natural susceptibility. So what is deficient will be filled in. Okay, so this space of vacuum will be filled and the susceptibility will be satisfied. Okay, then take the example of a healthy person. When we give homeopathic remedy to a healthy person, you know, what would happen is that an artificial susceptibility is produced, which is, you know, or we could say artificial drug disease is produced. Okay, like that. So, what does the law of susceptibility say? Susceptibility attracts into itself particular affinity of certain conditions because these are similar to constitutional conditions. Okay. For example, families suffer from similar ailments because their susceptibilities are such that they are prone to certain kinds of diseases. That is the reason why, you know, also in case taking, we emphasize a lot, you know, into, you know, past history or past history of, you know, what are the diseases that are running into the families also. So, that is it. So, let us just summarize. And what, according to Dr. Kent, its susceptibility is that it is the, you know, influx or the flow of causes into the body. Then according to Stuart Close, what it is, that it is the power of receiving impressions into the body and accordingly reacting to it. And third is, according to Dr. H.A. Roberts, it is the you know, state of vacuum. Okay, thank you all.
Dr. Vijay is asking, ma'am, where we can get previous recorded videos?
They are available on YouTube channel.
I have shared link, so just go to that link and just subscribe it.
Right now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So this is the email ID, drsanchita2509@gmail.com. So please, you all can mail your queries on this. Okay, then. Could we sign off for today, Dr. Yashashri, then?
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much again for wonderful explanation. And your slides are, as usual, it's amazing.
It's my pleasure, rather, to, you know, share my understanding with you all. So, I'll keep you posted for the next webinar. Thank you all and have a very good evening. Goodbye.